Dear students, myself Dr. Mallikarjun S. Biradar, Assistant Professor in Mathematics, Government First Grade College, Basavakalyan. Now the 44th session of Graph Theory 2, topic is the four color conjecture. In short, it is called 4CC. So in future, I may use this short way of mentioning the four color conjecture as 4CC. So it's very interesting topic, four color conjecture. See, in mathematics, if you state anything, something, then it is called a result. Unless and otherwise, if you prove the result, it won't be a theorem. Okay, it will be just a statement. Okay, if you say or if you state anything without proof, it won't be considered as a result. Okay, as a theorem. So why it is called a conjecture, why it is not called as a four color theorem? So all those things we are going to see in detail in this topic. Okay. What is four color conjecture? Actually, how we got this idea? What is the initiative for this? Let us think of the origin of four color conjecture. Actually, the four color conjecture was a long standing problem posed by Francis Guthrie to his professor Augustus de Morgan in 1852 while coloring a map of England. See, a student asked this question to his professor. What is the question that we will see? Okay. So the four color conjecture was a long standing problem posed by Francis Guthrie to his professor Augustus de Morgan in 1852 while coloring a map of England. Map, when I said in the beginning while giving the introductory about the colorability, so clearly a map is nothing but you can take that map as a plane graph. So clearly a map is a plane graph with states corresponding to faces. We should be able to color the faces of a plane graph in such a way that the adjacent faces, that is the faces sharing a common line, receive different colors. So while coloring the map, no two adjacent countries, no two adjacent states, or the countries with a common boundary, the states with a common boundary, so are called adjacent states. Okay, so no two adjacent states must have same color, no two adjacent countries have same color. So that is the idea beyond the coloring of a map. Okay, so you have to take that idea in your mind, that the plane graph in such a way that the adjacent faces, that is the faces sharing a common line, must issue different colors. Okay, let G be a plane graph, the map, that is the plane graph, and G star be its dual. You know how to construct the dual of a plane graph. The face coloring of G is equivalent to the vertex coloring of G star, because in the dual, every face corresponds to a vertex. The vertices of the dual are the faces of the graph G or the plane graph G. Okay, so that you know already. Okay, so now what is the statement of four color conjecture? The four color conjecture says, the four color conjecture, the statement is very simple. Statement says that any map on a plane or on the surface of a sphere can be colored with only four colors, so that no two adjacent countries have the same color. Very simple idea. You take any map or any planar graph, so that planar graph is only four colorable. Only four colors are sufficient to color a planar graph. So what is the statement of the four color conjecture? The four color conjecture states that any map on a plane or on the surface of a sphere can be colored with only four colors. Only four colors means it is not exactly four colors. Maximum four colors. Okay. At most four colors you can say. Maximum four colors. So that no two adjacent countries have the same color. So this is the country's map. In other words, in the graph theoretical idea, what you can say, the statement of 4cc is every planar graph is four colorable means maximum four colors. You can say three colorable also, two colorable also. So it is four colorable, maximum four colors we use to color any planar graph. Okay, that is the statement of the four color conjecture. Every planar graph is four colorable. Why it is called a conjecture? So that we will see. First, let me consider one example. For example, I have considered here a country having 10 states. Okay, so you can see here. So this is one state and there are 10. So, okay, this is a map of a country having 10 states. If you consider the state, you have to consider the districts. Okay, let us consider this as a country having 10 different states. So see, this is the state A, this is the state B. So I have labeled all the states with the names A, B, C, D, like that. Okay. Now this map is converted in terms of a plane graph. So how? Instead of a face, we took a vertex. Instead of the face B, we took a vertex. If two faces are having a common boundary or common line, here A and B are having a common line, so you have to join. So like that, A and C are also having common line, you have to join A and C. So like that, A and D are also having common boundary, you have to join A and D. Similarly, how about the vertices or the countries or the states with B and D? B and D are also having common boundary. How about B and C? There is no any common boundary between B and C. That's why B and D are adjacent, but B and C are not adjacent because there is no any common boundary between B and C. So like that, D and C are having common boundary, even E and D are having common boundary, even B and E are also having common boundary. So first, every state is considered as a vertex. And if any two states are having common boundary, you have to join those two vertices. If they are not having any common boundary, you should not join those two vertices. Okay. So like that, this is the map and this is the planar graph of the map. Okay. So let us try to color this one. We try to color this. So the planar graph of a map is colored with a minimum number of colors. So that is the aim. We want to reduce the number of colors so that the adjacent vertices are colored with different colors. That is the theme. That is the basic idea, fundamental idea in coloring. Then the colored map is shown in figure 2. Let me first try to assign the colors for the vertex A. Red. Now, A and B are adjacent. So when A and B are adjacent, you cannot assign the red color to B. You have to use some other color other than red. Say green. Okay. Now like that, if you consider the vertex D, so A is adjacent to D as well as B is also adjacent with D. So you cannot use the color red. You cannot use the color green. You have to use some other color. Say blue. So like that, if you color the graph in this way, so we have colored all the vertices, considering the adjacent vertices must have different colors. Considering that idea in the mind, we have colored all the vertices, all the 10 vertices. Okay, then what you have to do? The same map which you have considered one face as a vertex, for that face, you have to color the same color which you have assigned for the vertex. Say, for example, you have colored the vertex A by red. So A face, the face representing A is colored with red color. So like that, the face or the state colored with or representing the vertex B is colored with green. Like that, the face which you have or the vertex corresponding to that face, you have to color the same vertex or the same color which you have assigned for the vertices in the plane graph. So ultimately, the graph or the map looks like this. See, this is how a map is colored. With how many colors? 4 colors we have used. Okay, though it is a country with 10 states, but we have used only 4 colors. Okay, now the question arises. As I said, the statement is it is 4 color conjecture, means every planar graph is 4 colorable. Even we took one example, a map or a country having 10 states, so that the planar graph is colored with only 4 colors. So you may say that the statement is true. Now, why it is called a conjecture? That is a big question. Okay. Now we try to analyze this, or we try to think why it is a conjecture rather than a theorem. Again, I am going to consider a map. Okay, this is the map, a map of a country having 6 states. Compared to the previous one, there it was 10 states. Now I have considered a map with only 6 states. Okay, same way, what you have to do for every face, you have to label, or you have to label every face by a name, A, B, C, D, like that. Then one face represents one vertex. Okay, so like that, if two faces are having a common boundary line, you have to join those two vertices. If they are not having any common boundary, then you should not join. So like that, here, if you think in this way, let us, okay. Okay, so now, I have given the name for A, B, C, like this, A, B, C. So the state A is having a common boundary between B as well as C. So A is adjacent with B as well as C. Similarly, B and C are also having common boundary. So that's why I have joined like this, B and C. So like that, if I consider D, D is having a common boundary between A, common boundary between B, common boundary between C. It implies D is adjacent with A, B, C. Like that, if you consider E, E is having a common boundary between D, E is having a common boundary between B as well as C, but it has no common boundary between A. It implies E is adjacent with B and C. So E is adjacent with B and C. So like that, if you consider the state F, F is having a common boundary between E, similarly with B, even with the C. But F is not having a common boundary between A as well as D. That's why F is adjacent with only B and C. You can see here in the planar graph, F is adjacent with B and C. So see, the map is converted in terms of a planar graph. Now the coloring of map is nothing but coloring the vertices of the planar graph. Okay, so now try to color this planar graph. Okay, let us think in this way. Okay, so the same planar graph I will color in two different ways. There is no any restriction that you have to start with this vertex or that vertex. You can start with any arbitrary vertex. It is your choice. Only you have to remember two vertices which are adjacent must have different colors. That is the idea you have to remember in your mind. But there is no restrictions to start with this vertex or A or B or C like that. There is no any sequential order. It is your choice. So the same graph, see, you can see the previous one. The same graph I have considered here, Let me start the coloring in this way. Okay, let me clarify. Okay, I am trying to color this graph and starting with the vertex A. So A is colored with red color. Now A is adjacent with B and C. So you cannot assign red color to B and C. You have to assign B with a different color, say green color. Okay. When B is assigned with a green color, which is the green, is it a green color? Well, it is not a green. Okay. Like that you can say it is like a little bit pink type. Okay. Anyway, it is different color. So once if you assign this color to B, but C is adjacent with A and B, so you cannot use the red color as well as say the pink color. Okay, little bit different color. Okay, you cannot assign this. It implies you need to use the third color for this. So now it is your choice. I have colored A, B, C. Directly go to the top one, the vertex F. Choice is yours. See, if you ask a painter to paint the house, he may start with any of the rooms. But the thing is that his duty is to complete the coloring of entire building. So like that he has started with A and completed the coloring of the vertex B and C. Then directly we move on to the vertex F. Okay. Now F is adjacent with B and C. When F is adjacent with B and C, you cannot use these two colors assigned for B and C. You have to use other color. So I have used the color red because it is not adjacent with A. So that you can use because our aim is to reduce the number of colors. So you can use red color for F. Now I will think of E. So from top to bottom we are coming like this. After F we will consider the vertex E. But E is adjacent with D as well as B and C. So you cannot use the color for B and C used. You can use the other one. Okay, say black. Okay, even you cannot use the red color also. You cannot use red, you cannot use the color for C as well as B. You can use the other color. Okay, say black color. Now if you consider the vertex D, after E we are considering this. Okay, so now in this way if you color, if you observe the graph, how many colors we have used totally, you can come to the D, then you can think of D is adjacent with the A, B, C, like that. Even D is adjacent with E also. It implies D is adjacent with the three other vertices. It implies you cannot use those three colors, you have to use the other one. So like that, totally how many colors we have used? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we use 5 colors. Okay, so same graph I will consider and I try to color in a different way. First, see, in the same fashion, I start with A, then I will complete the coloring of B, C, considering the adjacent vertices and non-adjacent vertices that I in the mind. Then I will go in the way from top to bottom. Sorry, bottom to top. In the previous case, top to bottom. Now, bottom to top. So, we think of the vertex D, which is adjacent with A, B, C. So, you cannot assign these three colors, which you assigned for A, B, C. You have to use a different color for D. So, the fourth color. Now, you can think of the E. So, you cannot use the colors which is assigned for D, B, and C. But you can use the color which is used for A because E and A are non-adjacent. So like that you use the red color. Now if you think of F, F is adjacent with E as well as B and C. So you cannot use these three colors but you can use the black color. So like this, if you color in this way, we have used only four colors. The same planar graph, if you start from the top, first ABC, compulsory in both the cases. So in the first case from top to bottom, from F to D. In the second case from D to F, it is your choice. There is no any restriction to choose any arbitrary vertex. Okay. So only thing is that adjacent vertices must have different colors. So that should be the idea. So in the first way, from top to bottom, when we colored the graph, planar graph, we used five colors. So we used five colors. The same graph from bottom to top, that is from D to F, after completing ABC, we require only four colors. So the same graph, it requires five as well as four. It implies, where is the mistake in the first one? First we have colored ABC, then we have considered the vertex F, yes it is your choice, then we have colored ED. So we require five colors. The same graph, first we have considered ABC, then we have next considered D to F in the ascending order. Okay, so here we require only four colors, same graph, but here we require five, but here we require four. So of course the statement is, a graph, planar graph, is four colorable. Of course it is four, one or the other way it is four colorable, one or the other way it is four colorable, but the first one requires five, but the same graph we have recolored, the only way is different, so we have colored with four colors. So what I am going to say, one or the other way, the planar graph is colored with four colors, at most four colors. It implies, what you can observe, if you observe the coloring of the planar graph as shown in the previous graph, in the slide, previous slide, though we have followed the procedure of coloring the graph with minimum number of colors, so that the adjacent vertices are colored with different colors. One way, if we color in the first way from top to bottom, we require five colors. The same planar graph from bottom to top, we require four colors. So it is not known how to start the coloring. It's a question, how to start the coloring? Which vertex you have to consider first? What is the sequence? That we don't know. Okay, so that is the drawback. Simply, we are coloring any vertex, only considering in the mind that adjacent vertices must have different color. Okay, so only that is the idea, that is the condition, but there is no restriction on the vertices. But the first way, five colors, the same graph, the second way, four colors. So therefore, what I am going to say, till today, no one come with a planar graph with which requires, see, till today, no one come with a planar graph which requires more than four colors. It implies there is no planar graph which requires more than four colors. You may say, just now you use five colors, but the same planar graph is colored with four colors, one or the other way. So till today, no one come with a planar graph which requires more than four colors, or proved the result manually. Till today, there is no manual proof for the statement. So that is why there is no graph which requires more than four colors. There is no manual proof for the statement. So that's why it is called a conjecture. So why it is called a conjecture? Because of these two reasons, it is called a four color conjecture. I hope you have followed this. Statement is very simple. Every planar graph is four colorable. But till today, there is no manual proof, or till today there is no any planar graph who has come with a planar graph which requires more than four colors. So there is no graph, there is no proof. That's why it is called a conjecture. Manual proof is not there. So in this session, we have considered four color conjecture, how it come into existence, that is the origin of force AC, and what is the statement of the four color conjecture. Every planar graph is four colorable. Then why it is called a conjecture rather than the theorem. So that we have discussed in this session, that is four color conjecture. So these are the books for your reference. With this, we conclude this session. Thank you.